moving house can be one of the most traumatic events in a person's life. This is the story of two moves. Sam and Cynthia have their interstate move arranged by the Department of Administrative Services for the Commonwealth. Ray and Rita, inexperienced in removals, arrange their move without assistance.
I was just inquiring about your special economy moving offer. I was only wondering, it is cheap.
Cheap? Oh, we're cheap, all right. No frills here, you see. No fancy overhead, and we're very quick.
Oh, well, I was only wondering.
I'll just see if I can fit you in here.
Doesn't seem to be any problem there, Mr.
Murray. When were you planning on moving, Mr. Murray?
Oh, well, we were looking at the 8th, but I mean...
Good, good. And what's the address again, Mr. Murray?
14 Bowman Street.
Bowman Street, of course.
Right, well, we'll see you bright and early, Mr. Murray.
Don't you need to know what I...
I don't need to know nothing, Mr. Murray.
No, my motto is, you can sleep tight. It's fly by night. Zero.
Archibald Knight, call me Archie. Job's done right, it's fly by night.
Oh, Mr. Knight.
Hey, that's it, Bruce. Keep her coming. Keep her coming there, mate. Keep her coming there, Bruce.
It's a bit early, isn't it?
Early in, early out, as Shakespeare always said.
Have the rest of the day yourself.
That's it, Bruce.
Could you keep it down a little bit? My wife's still asleep.
Cut the noise, will you, Bruce? The old lady's trying to sleep.
Mr. Murray, this is me highly trained assistant, Bruce. Yeah, Bruce is my assistant. Now, as you must realise, with our super economy package, and you, of course, being our first customer for the day, a certain amount of customer participation will be called for. Customers always first, I always say. Oh, here you go, fill her up.
For the residents of 14 Bowman Street, this will always be a morning to forget. Dawn, and the Murrays experience fly-by-night removals. Already Ray has made two basic mistakes. No preparation for the move and not using common sense when things don't shape up. At this stage, it seems that the fly-by-night super economy deal has a few strings attached. Highly skilled assistant Bruce reveals his poor training.
Don't worry about these. The wife's a bit fussy about them, you know. We'll look after them.
Potted vegetation, that's one of our specialities. Just pop it in the back, it'll be packed away before you know it.
Right. Shouldn't your assistant be helping out here?
He can't be all places at once. Perhaps if you were to arouse your spouse.
Thank you.
amateurs, mate. Amateurs.
G'day, Jeff Felsted, Felsted Removals. Call me Jeff.
Hi, I'm Cynthia. We've been expecting you.
Pleased to meet you.
Come on in.
Thank you.
Unlike next door, things here are running smoothly. Already there is real communication on how the removal will go.
Well, I see from last week's inspection that you've done a detailed inventory. Right. Mm-hmm. Good, and you listed serial numbers and some brand names. That's very important. The secret to a good move is in the preparation.
That's what the Red Book said, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, we went by the book, all right.
Great. If more people had that attitude, everybody's job would be a lot easier. Now, has anything changed since the inspection?
No.
You see, if there are any items that need to be added, or taken off for that matter, I need to know so I can put it on the receipt voucher. Look, I know it's paperwork, but it means we all agree on what's to be moved.
That's great, isn't it?
Yeah. That's all part of the service, ma'am. This your first move?
How did you know?
I can always tell first-timers. Looks as though you're pretty well prepared, though. Now, the first thing to do is to go through the house, and then we can discuss our plan of attack.
I must admit, I was a little apprehensive being our first move. But Jeff, sorry, Mr. Felsted, was so helpful. He was delighted with the care we'd taken with the removal and how well the inventory was put together. He said it made the job easier. It took a bit of time to do it, but it's a necessary part of moving house.
I've put all the small ornaments on the inventory too.
Fridge going?
Yes, that's going.
Buffet?
Yes.
Freezer going?
Mm-hmm.
The cupboard going?
No, that's going to stay. There's the toaster, the Cambrook kettle, mm-hmm. and the Breville kitchenwares. They should be on the list as well. Settee going, the chair, the bookshelves, the cabinet here, the video and the television are also going, and I've given you the serial numbers for that, and that across there is also going.
Right. Oh, you've got a stain here, do you know about that? It's okay, I'll put it on the receipt voucher.
No problems.
By 5 to 8, the real professionals at number 16 were well underway, yet right under their noses, unusual activity was continuing. The only question was how long before the truth would be uncovered and by whom.
At first I wanted to help Jeff and the guys. I mean, I don't trust Sam with the good china. But I was surprised that everything got packed so well. Actually, Jeff let me into a little secret. He said when you've got professionals, let them do what they're being paid to do. That means both the packing and the unpacking. Jeff certainly is a pro, so who am I to argue? It's when no one knows what should happen. That's when things can go, wrong.
Assistant doesn't need a hand.
Well, it's a minor furniture alteration.
Look, I really think we should go and see what's going on.
Hang about, old boy. It's about time you realise just how much work we're saving you here.
Oh, well,
You go ahead, move the couch by yourself.
Oh, no.
Get the kitchen to load itself on the truck.
You can't, can you?
No. We're the professionals. You just leave it all to us. All you've got to do is round up a few bits and pieces.
There's no need to worry, see? You're doing the moving yourself, so you know what's happening.
My friend, this is one of the smooth...
This is
one of the smoothest moves I've seen. I bet your garage.
If it seems there's no rush with Sam and Cynthia, it's because they've done their homework beforehand. Their inventory covers the lot, small items too, like paintings and records and books. The cartons are marked with what's in them. They've got big appliances and small ones ready for the road. Cleaning, tying down, ready to go.
What was that?
Just probably something banging against the truck.
I hope it wasn't anything of mine.
Look, when you're moving furniture, you're bound to make a bit of noise, right? Wouldn't worry too much. We've got pros on both sides of the fence.
Get into a bit of a mess with your tools there, right?
No, well, Archie, you reckon...
Look, do you want an award for neatness or do you want it on the truck? Hey? Because that's what counts, fella.
Did anybody tell you what to do before you got into this, Ray? Did he go through anything? We got this, mate. Goes through the lot.
What's that?
Right, paperwork. Who needs it? Our motto, hands off. We'll look after you.
Yeah, I can see that. But in what condition, eh? Has he got a list of the things he's supposed to take?
Look, he's faster than your lot. You've been mucking around with your stuff for weeks.
Yeah, well, at least we know they've packed the right stuff and it'll get there.
Jeez, mate, what's on the truck is what he gets, okay?
Yeah, well, best of British, Ray.
While Sam was having another fight with Ray, I set to work in the bedroom. Clothes were the only thing we had to pack ourselves. And when it's time to unpack, clothes are all we have to worry about. The removalist is paid to unpack everything else on all moves arranged by the department. You can unpack the rest if you want to, but then you can't claim for any lost or broken items.
I'm nearly done.
All the guys have to do is put it in the truck. At the other end, I know what I've packed, because it's PBO, packed by owner.
Right. Carton to the garage.
At number 16, the packing's finished. All that's left for them to do is the all-important carton count. Communicating on how everything should be done has paid off. Last-minute additions go on the receipt voucher. If anything's lost or damaged, it's easy to check because it's right there on paper.
done?
We're professionals, sir. All that's been taken care of.
Now, where is my able assistant? As I said, all has been taken care of. And your furniture is in safe hands. Remember, you're right. Bye bye, night.
Having a spot of bother, Ray.
And Cynthia get their receipt, which Jeff and they have agreed on during the move.
Stereo spook and scratch on the top of it.
That's right, the left-hand corner.
That's right, okay. Well, are you happy with that? Like to sign down the bottom?
Yeah, sure.
Where is he?
You're going!
Wait, wait, wait.
Come back here.
Cynthia keeps her brown copy of the receipt. It will be put together with Jeff's copies and completed on delivery. Well, what's the lesson here? Read the Red Book thoroughly. Preparation pays. Do a complete inventory. Paperwork. It's important to do it properly. You'll need your copy of the receipt voucher for delivery. Common sense. If you think something's wrong, speak to the removalists. If you can't sort it out, contact the removalists' office or the Department of Administrative Services. Communication. Talk about possible problems and agree on how the uplift and delivery should go. And make sure the removalist has the right contact number. If not, good luck.
Tidiness of the place, broken furniture everywhere. The kitchen is a mess. Removalists shouldn't have to work in conditions like this. My assistant and I, we could catch anything in that kitchen. It's dreadful. I nearly caught something myself from that woman in the sheet. She's chasing me. The place is a mess in there. It's disgusting. Owners shouldn't own places like that.